So welcome. So do you wonder how at Amadeus we manage more than 1,500 Git repository CI/CD with just a few people and thanks to a full inner source solution? So hello, I am Gaël Selig from Amadeus, and in the next 15 minutes I will show you how we got there. Just a word about me. So I'm a principal engineer. I've been working at Amadeus for more than 10 years. I'm in Nice offices, so in the south of France, enjoying very nice sea and mountain view half of the week. And I'm mostly busy with cybersecurity. I'm an inner source promoter and contributor. I wrote the first white paper on inner source at Amadeus. And I'm also a trusted committer on a few projects. And to help me with this presentation today, let me introduce Danielle the dinosaur. So Danielle is my daughter's favorite toy, and it's also an alternative to a rubber duck programming. A few words about Amadeus. So Amadeus is we are a travel company. We are an IT company, and we are into travel. We are more than 18,000 people, half of them being developers. And so if you want to travel, if you want to take an airline, so you go probably to the airline website, and we support 400 of them. So chances are it will be Amadeus behind the scene. Or if you prefer a travel agency, it will be also Amadeus behind the scene. Then if you go to the airport to do your check-in, it will be an Amadeus terminal. And the boarding, the departure, it will be Amadeus departure control system. And in the plane, we do the flight balance also. It's again Amadeus behind the scene. And if after that you want to take a hotel, we support 1 million of them. So we are into airlines, rail, hospitality, and so on. And we manage the technology to board 4 million people per day. In terms of system, we have a quite a big system. We're handling 100,000 external transactions per second. It's an equivalent to Google search. And so in that, what are our challenges regarding the CI/CD? So the Amadeus code base, we have around 17,000 Git repositories using continuous integration and continuous delivery, CI/CD. Our CI/CD is based on Jenkins pipelines. And we support around 60,000 builds per day. Jenkins is a well-known open source server for handling CI/CD. And by build, the Jenkins terminology, it's actually a full CI/CD script. It's written in a file called Jenkins file. And the script usually for typically a code or a library, it will compute the version, do the compilation, the testing, the static analysis, security check. Deploy on the cloud, do some more tests, to connect with our change management, and so on. Question now is, how do we manage that? Should we copy-paste hundreds of lines of script in each of the 17,000 repositories? Clearly, this does not scale. And Daniel, we spend the day trying to maintain all this. Clearly, it will be a nightmare. So there should be a better way. So instead of duplicating, let's share. Well, this is the first part of our solution. To define common libraries, what we created the Pipeline Toolbox, which is an inner source library for reusable script, reusable function, can be used by anyone. So it's used by 10,000 repositories today. Pipeline Toolbox, it is a product with an owner. The owner is the central build infrastructure team. But half of the contribution come from the people outside of this team. So half of the pull requests are inner source pull requests. And to make everyone align, there is a channel for support and question. So it's Amadeus, we use Microsoft Teams. But the Teams channel with the build infrastructure team, the owner, the trusted committers, and the users, and also the contributors. And we see many advantages of doing so. First, the build infrastructure team is not a bottleneck. They are not a team to shoot a request and wait for ages to have it implemented. Instead, they are partners that helping us to deliver a fix or a feature. They are the trusted committers. Then, doing like this, the CI/CD knowledge is really shared across many Amadeus entities, so that if someone has an issue, there is always someone around who has knowledge about that. And finally, as a developer, it's much more satisfying to open a pull request and to contribute than opening a ticket and just wait for it to be implemented. So, it's very nice to share function. Like that, Daniel can do a much shorter script, but still need to duplicate. So how about going further and sharing the full CI/CD script? And that's what we do in since in 2017, the build infrastructure team provide us with the workflow framework, which is basically a script generator. It's an internal framework and it's based on another inner source pipeline. So that pipeline toolbox here, it's called pipeline framework. And thanks to that, we can have a Jenkins file of just 2 lines, and then that's it, no maintenance needed anymore. And the core of it is to have implementation of this workflow. Workflow is just a framework, but we need implementation for each technical stack we have at Amadeus. We have more than 60. And so we have workflow for standard technology like Docker, Maven, also a lot of internal tools. And the strength of that is that for large workflow, the large workflow are managed by communities of practices. Community of practice is an evolving group of volunteers with a common interest, and here is having a good CI/CD pipeline for their stack. And evolution, the support and the maintenance is all done by the volunteers in the community. So it's really built by user for users, but with a caring support of the central build infrastructure team. So if there is a global issue or question, the team is here. But if the community is quite autonomous, no problem, it doesn't add extra workload to the team. So let's have a focus on Maven workflow. So it's the workflow implementation for the Java and Maven stack, which is quite popular at Amadeus. And so, as I said, just 2 lines in the Jenkins file. So this is a real code. Huh? It's really what we have in our Jenkins files. So calling the pipeline framework and then calling the stack here, the Maven stack. This Maven workflow is used by more than 1,500 repositories. And all that without any strong incentive to do so. Huh? People are not obliged to use Maven workflow if they are playing with Maven. But we just did a lot of communication around it and support in the Teams channel, but no obligation, but still we are quite impressed when you start to do some monitoring to have so many people are using it. So we are 33 contributors and it's 100% in inner source. So no one is paid full time to work on Maven workflow. It is managed like all big workflow by a community of practice. We call that e-commerce pipeline community. And we are 4 trusted committers, so I will be the main maintainer, but there are other people to help me with that, to review pull requests. And we have a dedicated channel for the support and evolution when anyone can post a question, a proposal of evolution or an issue, and other users can help answer that. So you can see an example of such a run pipeline, so doing like build test, check security check, cloud deployment thanks to Helm and many other things. Just an unrelated question now. You know that Daniel is made of plastic. Plastic is made from oil, and oil is partially made from dead dinosaur. How much real dinosaur is there in Daniel? Get the answer later. Let me share with you some lessons learned from this adventure to go to this full inner source system, which is working pretty well for us and supporting so many repositories with not so much work for the community. Some key feature for adoption. So first critical thing is the documentation, like Daniel said at the previous talk. So we don't have the capacity to support everyone personally. So the documentation must be super clear and up to date to avoid any question. Like we said, hundreds of people implemented this workflow without even me noticing. So the documentation must be super clear. And to do that, we also push the documentation on our internal wiki. This is done part of the CI/CD of the workflow. Yes, because of course we have a workflow to build workflow. And doing this CI, we push that to our internal wiki so that all the documentation of all workflow are put together. It's easy to browse, it's easy to search. And so it's written quickly it's in Markdown and then converted to wiki pages. So like that, we have a single source of truth. Documentation as code, so it's reviewed when there is an evolution, the documentation is reviewed together with the code. So we're sure it's always up to date. And doing that, it encourages people to contribute, even if it's a small change like documentation. And personally, when I did my first contribution in the open source world, was a few years ago. It was in Kibana software. It was just that something was missing in the documentation. So I had no idea of the technical stack behind Kibana, but I just did this pull request to just add some clarification. And I was super proud to have it merged. And I saw that it was super easy, in fact, to just open a pull request. People will wait commit, add a few comments, and it worked very smoothly. And so that's what we would show also to encourage people to give incentive to just contribute. It's easy, and you don't need to be a super expert, and people will be here to help and to support you. Second point is about the support. So first thing, in the documentation, we clearly state that Maven Workflow is a community product. There is not a 24/7 official support. You cannot send tickets to Maven Workflow. But in case of issue, there is a reactive chat. And for sure, we will find users or maintainers that will be able to help you and to be able to help to solve your problem yourself. And by doing that, the people that was helped by the community will gain some knowledge, will understand how the workflow is working. And so it will grow the knowledge base in the company, and people will also be able to help others facing similar issues. So it's really important to make it not a black box, but a product that belongs to everyone. And finally, about the stability. So we always encourage to always use the latest version of the workflow. But if there is a big issue, of course, we can revert. It happened to me in the past months. Just revert the commit if there is an issue, no problem. But also, we must have a super stable workflow. And to ensure this and the backward compatibility among with other standard unit testing and integration testing, we have some template projects that we use for regression testing in the CI/CD of the workflow itself, so that it represents how users usually use the workflow, because the workflow is super extensively, you can extend it, you can configure it a lot. So we cannot test 100% of all the options, the combination of options, but we try to test standard ways of using the workflow. But if a user complains about the stability, that often in the recent evolution it was broken, we encourage this user to create a template project and to add it in the regression testing of the workflow, so that it will be tested each time and there won't be any issue in the future. Okay, so just a word about the future. So in Amadeus, we are moving our CI/CD stack. We are moving from Bitbucket to GitHub and moving from Jenkins and Jenkins pipeline to GitHub Actions. And you know, there is a built-in workflow framework equivalent in GitHub, but we are implementing the Maven workflow in GitHub with GitHub Action. So here we are completely changing the technical stack, but we will keep the strengths of the inner source with a community-based inner source approach. We'll just have to change the technical stack, but we will keep our strengths. So in conclusion, the inner source, it is really a key asset for our CI/CD platform, and that cannot work without it. Of course, it requires some effort to put in place and to have an active community behind it, but it's totally worth it. And if you want to do so, just pay attention to the documentation, the support, and the stability. Thank you very much.